Hello everybody. Today's my topic is Anonaceae family, commonly called as custard apple family. I am from Government City College, lecturer in botany. Myself is Sunita. Now coming to the classification of Anonaceae family. Anonaceae is the most primitive family among all the dicotyledons, which is placed after Ranunculaceae. It is the most primitive, but it is having commercial value because of custard apple, Anonas famosa, and a number of species of Anona belongs to this family, and which is a wild variety and also cultivated fruit nowadays. Now the classification of Anonaceae. Division Spermatophyta. Division Spermatophyta means seed produced plants. Phyta means plants, sperma means seeds. The plants which produce seeds, that is spermatophyta. Now subdivision angiosperms. So we are talking here angiosperms means which are the highly developed plants which are occupied more place on the earth. Majority of the plant kingdom is consisting of angiosperms itself. Now the angiosperms divided into dicotyledons and monocotyledons according to the natural system of classification. So in that dicotyledons are placed first because majority of are there and more primitive than monocotyledons. Hence dicotyledons comes first, and we have to learn dicotyledons before the monocotyledons itself because of the some primitive characters. Dicotyledons means the seeds which consist of two cotyledons at the embryonic stage, they are all comes under dicotyledons. Approximately 202 families are there in dicotyledons. Now coming to dicotyledons, it is divided into polypetale, gamopetale and monoflagellate, three subclasses. Now the first subclass is polypetale. Polypetale means petals are free. That is the first primitive. The main character which is divided dicotyledons into three subclasses on the basis of petals, union and free. So polypetale means not many. Petals are free. They all come under polypetale. Now this polypetale divided into three series. Thalamiflorae, Disciflorae and Calyciflorae. The first series Thalamiflorae, which is we have to learn now, and numerous stamens, numerous corpels, three petals, three sepals, and these are the some characteristic features of series Thalamiflorae. Now under the Thalamiflorae order is Ranelis. This is the first order of the dicotyledons. So in that we have, today we are going to learn about the Anonaceae family. Anonaceae family is the most first primitive family among all the dicotyledons. It is commonly called as custard apple family. Now coming to some diagrammatic pictures of custard apple fruit plant. Look at this picture. This is the custard apple and these are the connected anthers, and this is the ovary, monocarpellary, monolocular, and these are the corpels, and this is the floral diagram. Now coming to the general characters, in brief, wood is aromatic. Wood is aromatic means wood consists of some dotted glands and scented, and coming to leaves, they are estipulate and brief characters. Floral parts are usually numerous, means sepals, petals, mainly essential organs. Anisham consists of numerous stamens, and gynisham consists of numerous corpels. Hence the floral parts are considered as numerous, and they are freely spirally arranged on the thalamus. Stamens with a distinct enlarged and flat connective, and gynisham is multipistillate and many pistilla, many corpels are present, and all they are apocarpous. Apocarpous means three corpels. Now going to next. Habit and habitat. Habit means how they, what is the morphological structure and what is the body, what is the shape and what is the height of the plants belongs to the Anonaceae family. Habitat means where they are grown. And coming to habit, majority of the plants of Anonaceae are trees itself. Trees means which are big and very much branched, and the earth is occupied mainly on the trees. Then some are shrubs and some are very pure lichens. And coming to the important family character, Atrabotrys odoratimus is the best plant which belongs to this family. It is a climber, climbing with the help of hook. Hook means curved, pointed, sharp peduncle is modified into hook in Atrabotrys. This is the important feature of this family. Atrabotrys odoratimus is the family member which climber, woody climber. The climber means with the help of hook it is climb. The hook is modified peduncle. Peduncle is nothing but flower star. And majority of the family members' leaves consist of oil ducts. And on the bark also, bark means the upper surface layer of woody trunk. The bark also consists of oil ducts. And the leaves are perianth leaves, or leaves are also consist of oil. Next, terrestrial. Terrestrial means landed plants, which are grow on the soil. Perennial means many years they survive. The lifespan of these family members are many years. Evergreen means always they are fresh, they do not dry and they are not wither away. Deciduous means they fall off according to the season. And majority nowadays custard apple is cultivated because of the commercial value. It is an edible fruit for everyone and found liked fruit by all the human beings. Hence nowadays it is cultivated separately as well as automatically it is grown on the hills, on the rocks, in the forest as a wild. Now going to the next vegetative characters. Now vegetative characters means the plant parts, root, stem, leaves comes under vegetative characters. The vegetative characters means first we will talk about root. Root is taproot system because of it is dicotyledon. And it is very deeply present in the soil and extensively branched means very profusely branched because of the trees. The morphologically habit if we see majority are the trees, hence the taproot system is well developed and deeply extensively present in the soil. Now coming to the stem. Stem is nothing but which is give support, mechanical support to the plant body, which is aerial, always it is erect in majority of the family members and it is branched. The branches are profusely developed. Solid. Solid means woody and stout. Sometimes some climbers also visible in this family. Best example, Atrabotrys odoratimus. So woody climber is also there. Now the third aerial part is leaves. Leaves are nothing but which are external, which do the photosynthesis, which are very simple, and the leaves are entire and simple, entire, alternate. If you note axis means at each node opposite with each other leaves are arise, stipulate, stipules are absent. Distichous means they may be divided into two leaves member and dotted gland dots are present on the leaves. So this is about the vegetative characters. Now coming to the floral characters. Floral characters are nothing but it starts with the inflorescence. Inflorescence means arrangement of flowers. Arrangement of flowers and the number of the flowers. The flowers are arranged on the peduncle. Flower inflorescence stalk is called peduncle. Individual flower stalk is called pedicel. If number of flowers are present on the axis, that is called peduncle, inflorescence axis. So on the basis of number of flowers, on the basis of size of flowers, inflorescence is divided into racemose, cymose and special. This we studied it in the inter level itself. Now coming to this family, inflorescence is solitary. Solitary means it comes under cymose type of inflorescence, means limited number of flowers. It means only one or two flowers are arise at the axillary position on the stem. So the position of flower is axillary. The number of flowers is one only itself. Solitary means single or one. So solitary or simple, and axillary is the common type of inflorescence in Anonaceae family. And sometimes we can find out cauliflorus in the group. Cauliflorus means in some examples of the members of Anonaceae, we will find out cauliflorus means the flowers are arise on the surface of the stem and branches. So inflorescence is very simple. Solitary is very common, and very few cases we can find out cauliflorus and axillary position. Now we will study and we go about flower. Flower means it is the main important for each and every family. Floral characters make a lot. Because of the floral characters only, we can differ one family to other family. Mainly the classification system is based whether it is pentamine hooker or englerine tranter or tartajan, whatever it may be, whether it is natural or artificial or phylogenetic type of classification, it is mainly depend upon the floral characters only. Why? Because flowers are differ from one plant to another plant. But the area vegetative parts, if we see take 10, if we see number of plants, so all the leaves look similar, all are green in color, all are broad, simple, stem is erect and branched. That is very difficult to differ one plant to another plant by considering of vegetative characters. But if you see flowers, rose is different, jasmine is different, and sunflower is different. Like that, several flowers, the chrysanthemum is marigold is different. Like that, several flowers which are available in the market for different purposes. On the basis of floral characters only, we can define this is what, this is rose plant, this is jasmine plant, this is marigold plant, this is dahlia plant, like that. So floral characters makes a lot for the classification of families. Now coming to this Anonaceae family, flower in detail if we see, actinomorphic is the first character. Actinomorphic means that it tells about the symmetry. For looking, the flower is beautiful and it shows a proper structure and a symmetry will be proper. Actinomorphic means actually if we cut the flower into two pieces in any way, we will get two equal parts, same parts. That is the meaning of actinomorphic. The symbol is round and plus in the center. But some in Monodora we can find out zygomorphic. Zygomorphic is the common in Monodora. Why? Because zygomorphic is the advanced than actinomorphic. Where we can find out zygomorphic type of symmetry means if the flower's petals are in different sizes. The size of the petals in a flower is one is small, one is big, one is large, like that. The zygomorphic symmetry will be visible. That is advanced than the actinomorphic. So Anonaceae is the primitive family. In general, majority of the Anonaceae family members are show actinomorphic only. One or two Monodora like that, they show zygomorphic due to the difference in size of the petals. Then unisexuality. Unisexuality is the very rare case in this family. Bisexual flowers are very common. Unisexual is the advanced character, that is we will find out in Stylococarpus. Unisexual means female and male flowers are present separately. But bisexual means single flower having two sex organs. Androecium and gynoecium, if both are present in the same flower, that is bisexual. If the flowers are consist either androecium, gynoecium, the male and female flowers are separate, that is called unisexuality. And now complete, if the flower consists of all four floral parts, calyx, corolla, androecium, gynoecium, the flower is called complete. So it is the common character and it is also a primitive character. If any one of the flower part is absent in the flower is called incomplete. So unisexual flowers are incomplete itself, because unisexual male flower in male flower, gynoecium undadu, female flower lo androecium undadu. So this is about complete. Primorous means presence of three petal, presence of three sepals is the common feature of this. This trimerous number of petals and sepals in limited is also one primitive character. Hypogynous. Coming to the thalamus or the receptacle, where the ovary is arise above the thalamus and below from the ovary do andrishema and calyx corolla arise, that is called hypogynous. This is also one primitive character. In Eupomacia is the one example which exhibits perigynous, where the superior and of inferior ovary is present in the Eupomacia and often aromatic. Often aromatic means you will find the flowers are also show the some aromatic scented dotted glands. Now coming to the calyx, this is the first floral part of the flower. Calyx is the first nodal part of the flower, which consists of sepals. In Anonaceae, they are three in number. If they are cephaloid, means they are very big, look like a petal, that is called cephaloid. Polycephalous means free. The sepals are free, which is not united with each other, that is called polycephalous. And pronated, the base means little bit, they touch with each other and they are broad. In a base, they are broad. Coming to up, they are narrow. If you see the floral diagram, you will find out very easy to understand. Pronated at the base means broad at the base. Coming to up, it is narrow. Volvate aestivation means very primitive character. The margins of the sepals are very far with each other and they are not united. They are not overlapped with each other. That type of aestivation is called volvate aestivation. Now coming to the corolla. Corolla means which consists of petals. Generally, the petals are three, but in sometimes six are also present. If they are six in number, they present each two whorls of each three. And volvate aestivation is the very common, same as it is, without overlapping of each other. Slightly imbricate will be find out in some of the genera. And sometimes no distinction into sepals and petals. Means that is the one thing we have to, because of the primitive nature of this characters of this family, sepals and petals are not differentiated, so perianth is called as it, and they are also in three number or maybe more than three. If they more than three or six, they present in two whorls, in each whoral three. If they are numbering nine, they present in three whorls, each in three, but in maximum either three or six petals are present. Now coming to the andrishema. Andrishem means stamens. This is the third floral part. Just now we are calyx, corolla. They are non-essential organs. They are indirectly help in the pollination. They are called non-essential. But coming to the andrishem, this is the third floral part, which is male's reproductive part, which consists of stamens. Here in Anonaceae, stamens are numerous, spirally arranged on the axis. When we are eating fruit, we will find out a stout like small central axis is visible to us. We will throw after removing all the seeds and fruits. So that is the central axis, which forms a large convex receptacle. And each andrishem consists of numerous stamens. The stamens filaments are very short. Each stamen consists generally two parts. One is filament, one is anther. Filament is short and thick. Anthers. Filament is short and thick. Anthers are long. And extrodes. Extrodes is also one of the primitive character. And coming to the anthers, diathecus. Diathecus means two theca are present. Each theca consists of two locules. And two thecas consist of four locules. It is a common feature, primitive character. Tetralocular. It is nothing but tetralocular. And why andrishem is essential? Because of it is a male reproductive part of the flower. And it is directly participate in the pollination. This andrishem, anthers produce pollen grains. Those pollen grains transfers to the stigma by different carriers or by different vectors. That is called pollination. When they reach to the stigma, they germinate and they enter into the ovary through the pollen tube. With the help of pollen tube, through the style, they enter into the ovary and their embryo sac is present, fertilization occurs. That is different. But andrishem produce pollen grains. Now coming to the gynoecium. Gynoecium is the last and fourth floral part of the flower. Gynoecium is female reproductive organ. Carpels are numerous in gynoecium. Carpels means if you cut any fruit, we will find out the chambers. For example, when we cut the lady's finger, this is a common vegetable what we use in our daily routine to eat. So we will find out 5 or 6 chambers. So the chamber is called locule, and the surrounding layer wall is called carpel. So here, this Anonaceae family, custard apple is the best example. We will find out so many fruitlets. So it means that carpels are numerous. Very rarely they are few. And they are free. Usually they are free. So that's what we are picking one fruitlet and eating and enjoying the custard apple fruit. Now spirally arranged on the raised receptacle. So we will find, when we take the custard apple to eat, we break into 2 pieces. In the center, one small stout axis is present, you know, that is the receptacle. So on that receptacle, spirally, so many carpels are present. After that fertilization only, they turn into fruit. That is very easy to understand. Now, apocarpus. Each and every one is easily we can remove and eat it. So, apocarpus. Superior. Ovary is superior because of the hypogynous flower. And superior is the very most primitive. The first families, what we learned in dicotyledons, almost all they show the superior ovary, still umbelliferae. Now unicarpellary, unilocular, ovules, one to many, ovules are anatropous. Ovules are inverted. Anatropous means inverted ovules. So if we see the structure in brief, ovule consists of micropyle and pinnacle, stalk of the ovule and chalaza. If they are present in these 3 parts are present in straight line, the ovule is called arthrotropous. But that is also very uncommon. Anatropous ovules are present in the majority of the plants. Anatropous means inverted. Inverted means the body of the ovule is bent either 90 degrees or 180 degrees, and they are curved. They are micropyle reached near to the pinnacle. So that is called anatropous. Style short. Style means the above the ovary, small elongated neck-like structure is present. No, that is the style, that is called, that is short. Or maybe it is not visible. Stigma also very small. And in Monodora, syncarpous ovary. This is the rare case. In Monodora, ovules are united with each other. Carpels, syncarpus and parietal placentation. Now coming to the fruit. Fruit is very important here, very commercial valuable. It is a kind of aggregate of berries. Berries means simple fruits and fleshy with single seeded. And in ananas, cramoja, custard apple, it is an aggregate fruit. It is a single compound aggregate fruit. It is made up with the berries. Now coming to the seed. Seeds are very large. We will find out very black and they are endospermic. Now, pollination. Pollination means transfer of pollen grains from anthers to the stigma. So it is generally in majority of the family members, pollination is by insects, that is known as entomophilic due to paddy and synthetic. One type of smell, not a very good fragrant. Gaddy means sticky and scented flowers are present, you know. Hence, due to that, insects are attracted and they do the pollination. Now, coming to the economic importance. Starting only, I said they are cultivated as well as wild because of Anona species. All are freshy fruits, very juicy and edible. And they are also nowadays we are getting ice creams of Anona cramoja, custard apple, soft drinks are available in the market. Jellies are also available in the market of the custard apple. So hence it is cultivated nowadays. Recent analysis showing that almost 18% of the sugars are present in the custard apple. But people are telling that doctors are telling to the diabetic patients not supposed to eat custard apple regularly because of the high content of sugars. Now, edible fruits are also obtained from various species of Annona and Asimia. Timber is also available. Timber means wood, which is used to make furniture. Some examples of timber yielding plants of Annonaceae is nothing but Bacogia variegata, Bacogia larifolia, Sciatocalyx gelanica, Lugitia pitarensis, Oxandra lanceolata, Eupomachia lariana, which are useful timber. Timber means whether they used in furniture making or whether they used in cots, doors, windows, tables, all the furniture which is useful in our daily life, all they made up of from the wood or timber. So, some of the examples. Now, not only the timber and edible, we will get some oils. The oils which are not edible, which are used in perfume making industries. The oil, Maksara oil, which is available from the flowers, are extracted from the flowers of Desmos chinensis. The perfume is also obtained from the Kiluwa fragrance, and it is specially liked by Arab women. So oils are, here some oils are available also extracted from this plant. Now fiber. Fiber means the bark of Goniothalamus vitigi produces strong fiber. Fiber means like jute, which is used commercially, which is used in the rope making, mattress making, and doormats like that. Now ornamental. Ornamental, just now I said, Artra botrys odoratus. It is the best beautiful climber, woody climber, which is belongs to this, which is beautiful and scented, hence it is cultivated in the gardens and in the parks as the ornamental. Annona discolor, which is in different color, that is also cultivated due to their scented flowers. Desmos chinensis is also ornamental tree. So this is about the brief economic importance of this family, and it is the most useful nowadays custard apple. Everyone, it is a seasonal food, even though everyone is liking to eat. So the brief description of the custard apple, and thank you for patient listening.